The drama started just around supper time last night. That's when a resident in this building went to Royal University Hospital's emergency room. Luckily for the 50 people in the building, the emergency room doctor went with his instincts. Dr. Mark Waba suspected carbon monoxide poisoning, so he called the fire department. They sent a crew to check out the building. It was a life-saving decision. Jean Romero lives in the building and says she's still shaken by what could have happened.
Very scary because I am scared for my family because I'm supposed to work night last night. What if it happened midnight when I'm gone and my family are sleeping? I came home in the morning, they might be dead.
Firefighters found potentially lethal carbon monoxide levels in the building. 200 parts per million in the hallways, 400 parts per million in the boiler room. Anything above 50 parts per million will trigger an evacuation. The 50 people in the one building were evacuated. Half went to hospital right away, the remaining to housing arranged by the Salvation Army. Inspectors then went through the building, top to bottom. It appears it all started with venting issues in the boiler room. That's not all they found.
Confirmed with the fire inspector on scene that they did not have carbon monoxide sensors. So that he is looking at alternative solutions moving forward for the two buildings that will remain occupied as well as the four. So he is in discussion with Sask Energy.
Fire inspectors checked out the other buildings in this complex. That's when a second unit was evacuated. Now, it's not clear when the people will be allowed back into these buildings, but when they do go back, there will be carbon monoxide detectors in the buildings. Dan Zakreski, CBC News, Saskatoon.